10 photographers are competing for a chance to win over $25,000 in cash and prizes. Today's episode challenge is soft light beauty portraits. Are they up for the challenge? Let's see what they can do. Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
I want to step out of my element a lot.
Sorry, I'm not used to that.
10 minutes is not enough time to do anything.
You got other problems.
I did absolutely nothing that I had intended.
That's beautiful.
Chef's kiss.
Today, three photographers are going home. So who will it be? Creators, welcome to season two. Today's challenge is soft light beauty portraits. At stake for the series winner, over $25,000 in cash and prizes from Canon, H&H Color Lab, Background Town, and Westcott. A few of the rules for this year, some things have changed. First, every image will be created in studio, so it'll be up to your lighting, posing, composition that must stand out. You'll have your choice of backgrounds from Background Town. Each challenge winner will have a chance to win a prize. And this year, due to viewers' demand, the winner will be selected first during elimination. You will have 10 minutes to complete your challenge. After you complete your challenge, you'll hand me your card and return to the lounge. Once every competitor has completed their challenge, your cards will be returned and you'll have 30 minutes to edit. And finally, the challenge winner will hang in the H&H Wall of Fame. Today's challenge is soft light beauty portraits, and the winner of today's challenge will take home a 30 by 40 edge print from H&H Color Lab valued at $350. Do not take this challenge lightly. I found that the simpler the challenge, the more difficult it is. Remember, this is a competition and the judges are looking for a standout winner. Today's model is Brooklyn Circle. Come on out this way, Brooklyn. Give it up for Brooklyn. All right, so good luck, competitors. Let's see who goes first, so you know the drill. You're going to walk over there and pick a card to see who goes first and who goes last. Where's your card?
I get the last one. Here it is.
Let's see him. What do we got? Who got number one? Oh, Chris Grande. Who got number 10? Andre.
Andre's number 10, are you kidding me?
Are we bartering, are we trading, or no, we're keeping our numbers. All right, so Chris, you're staying with me. Everybody else, you're into the lounge. Headphones in, get ready for your chance. All right, let's talk about the giveaway for today's winner from H&H Color Lab. This is their fine art edge print, but in this edge collection print, you can get it in fine art, you can get it in metal, or you can get it in canvas. This comes in anywhere from 8x8 to 30x40 in size, and of course, fine art paper, metal, and canvas. And this is a product I personally have in my home. We did a video on it recently, so we've been hanging our own travel prints. It's absolutely stunning, and it's one that's going to allow you and your business to stand out. Want a chance to win H&H's featured product today? Go down into the description, click on the link, and head over to our website. There, you'll enter to win, and every week, someone will win the featured product from H&H. All right, Chris, what's your lens choice? We're using the Canon R5. What are you going with for a lens?
I think I'm gonna go with my bread and butter, the 85-1.2.
All right, 85-1.2. I'm gonna get this set up for you. I'm teching for you today. This is yours. Let's go pick backgrounds. You know, picking your backdrop shouldn't be the challenge. We got other problems.
I think I'm gonna go the Lux Olive.
Annie's Lux Olive. Okay, girls, let's get it set up. What do you wanna do for light?
I think I'm gonna do the big beauty dish.
Big beauty dish, okay. Don't forget, Chris, we have a Octa Large Manny Ortiz beauty dish.
And I'm gonna go Manny Ortiz.
You want the Manny Ortiz?
Yeah, okay.
Perfect. Power's at 6.3. Everything else is dialed in for you. If you wanna change power settings, it's literally just up and down.
Okay, up, okay.
Yeah, but if you get stuck, I'm here to help you.
Got it.
I'm gonna give you your first test frame, and then timer starts. Brooklyn, you ready? Here, you want the light here? Tell me what to do.
Let's bring the light in a little bit and feather it off this way a little bit.
Giving them one test shot free. Next one's gonna cost them. Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
Okay, love your hands there. Just kind of like, yeah, light fingers. Bring your chin this way some. Yeah. Look towards me for one. You're like Jackie O right now. Look like right, so not that far, like right there. Yeah. Right there, yep.
I do like what he's doing. He's directing a lot. Really good communication. Doing great on time, Chris. We're at 8:20. Reflector?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm on it. I'm teching. That's a fail. You just want it opposite light or you want it underneath?
Underneath more.
Okay. Let me see. You don't know what it looks like yet. Okay, that looks really good.
Yeah. Pick a spot. Love it.
So where you at? Where you at mentally? Talk me through it. You've got a shit ton of frames, but what are we trying to do now? It's 6 minutes left.
I feel like I got a good one in the can. Can I add a hair light?
Yeah.
No, I want it opposite, like here.
Okay. 4.5 minutes, time check. Hair light looks phenomenal. I think we just got to go a little higher with it, Chris. 3:50.
Right there. Yep. There. Yeah. Bring your chin up even further. Yep. Love this. Go hands here again.
2.5 minutes. 30 seconds.
I got nothing else.
All right. 20 seconds left. Chris has called it. Good job, man. Brooklyn, good job.
Oh my gosh, that was so great. This is my bread and butter, doing soft light beauty with high school seniors and stuff. Moms love it. It's what I know. I think my struggle was that it's so simple that I didn't have enough to think about. So, you know, you start overanalyzing the tiniest details, but I think I got some really great expression. I messed around with lights. I got what I thought was a good shot in the can, and then I started messing around with lights, adding things, taking things away, and I think I got chef's kiss.
All right, here we go. Next up, who's number two? Who's number two? All right, let's go, baby. You ready? What are we going with today? What do you want to pick for a lens?
I want to do the 85.
85 millimeter. Well, let's go over here for lighting. You want to go with this?
Yes, a 3.4.
Okay.
Are we able to do rim lighting with the?
Yeah, what we can do, you want a strip for the rim?
Yeah, just a strip.
You have the ability to pick any backdrop you want for that.
Woo.
Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes. Okay, let's go. Rock and roll, baby.
Good. Give me some good smiles. And scoot over just a little bit right there, because I want to make sure we're good and soft.
8.5 minutes, Deshaun.
Are we able to?
We can do whatever you want.
Okay. I want to get something shiny, sparkly.
Something shiny, sparkly for what?
So, yeah, to shoot through.
Okay.
Right, 3, 2. Okay, 3, 2.
What do you think? That's interesting.
I really did. I like that.
Okay. Ooh, okay, let's make that perfect, man.
Okay.
I'm just saying, when it comes to assistants, I'm probably one of the best.
You are the best.
See, he agrees. All right, we're gonna get a bar glass. Go ahead, run back there. Deshaun, it's on you. I'm not running.
About to work through this glass.
3 minutes. All right, here we go. I'm going as fast as I can, Deshaun. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time.
Yes, good job, thank you.
Good job, buddy.
Thank you.
Brooklyn, good job again. I've got to shoot Lucille Ball, and she's yet alive through our model.
I was ready to be through with the first few shots, but then I had to get creative, and trying to add color and try to add atmosphere was like hell. So hopefully I got something with the things we added. So who knows? I got something good, so I'm ready to check it out.
Here we go, who's up next? Number 3. Let's go, girl.
Let's
go.
What are we picking for a lens?
85,
okay.
I'm gonna have this in front of her.
Okay, so the Manny Ortiz.
And then I'll have this as for hair light.
Okay.
Going off colors, ooh. I think this is gonna tell the story I want it to tell. She is the Brooklyn Circle. She is the hottest jazz singer of the time.
Okay.
She wants to be a star. She's gonna be shining bright. Let's do it. My plan is, I saw Brooklyn, her hair, she looks stunning. I immediately thought vintage vibe. She's a star. She's a singer. She's the hottest jazz club singer. I want her to be desired in this image. Lighting wise, I'm thinking that I'm gonna be nice and soft with the beauty dish, make sure she gets fully covered. Then I'm gonna have that hair light to kind of separate her from that beautiful light in the backdrop. And then once I get the shot that I want technically correct as I can, I'm going to try and add in an extra flavor with the optical stuff.
So I'm gonna let you get 2 test frames and then the clock starts.
I have the X2M, you know, I don't have this one yet.
Well, it's the X3.
I know, I need a level up.
The latest. You didn't think we were bringing the old shit to
no,
the program,
absolutely
did you?
Not.
Come on,
absolutely
Carolina.
Not.
What kind of amateur production would this be? Hey Siri, set timer 10 minutes.
Body facing this way, and then your face leaning towards the light, like if you are turned towards facing towards the light, like if you are reaching for that off star, you are her. That's the
You're
story.
You're happy, nothing we need to change?
When you ask me that song, you make me question.
No, no, I'm making sure you're happy. I'm just here to provide service for you.
I'm happy. I want to make sure I perfect before I even go on any
Good call. I like it. So time check, 6.5 minutes.
All right, we're doing great. Lift. I'm grabbing you by the nose. I'm lifting you. Sweet. I'm doing this one. Beautiful.
What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to soften it just a little bit.
I think it's going to be hard no matter what, just because it's it's a spot. 1 minute. This is hard light. Not soft.
You can't talk. I'm not going to use these. It's okay.
Okay, as long as you're not using them.
Because I know what I'm doing wrong.
A little pro tip.
I feel good.
You feel good.
I feel good.
You're happy.
I came to this super chill, so.
All right. She's super chill. All right, time.
I came into it automatically knowing what I wanted to do. I kind of figured the story that I wanted to tell. The rest was just the posing and the lighting. I knew I had to get my safe shot first. I knew that technically speaking, they are going to be zooming in and checking my stuff out. And if I slip, they're going to call me for it. So I made sure I got my safe shot. I feel good with the practice that I've had, the experience that I've had setting up the shot. I got it almost immediately, but I went and made sure I perfected those little things that I could see behind the screen. And then I decided to play with the rest of my time. And I don't think I regret that decision. Yeah, it didn't go exactly the way I planned, but I created the image that I had in my mind. So just have fun with it.
Right, let's talk about all the backgrounds that are being used right now. So these are all from Background Town, thousands to choose from. But one of the things we selected for the show were fleece. And so one of the reasons I love fleece, and I know you can't feel it, but it's like having a fleece blanket. And one of the things that make these cool, because we have backdrops made of all sorts of materials, is how easy they travel, pack, store without getting wrinkles in them. So I wouldn't say they're wrinkle-free, but we can fold these up, hang them out, and they are gonna look incredibly flawless on the background. Also, because of the material it's made out of, it's not super reflective. You know what I'm talking about? When you're in studio and you're firing strobes, it's gonna reflect and you get a bunch of sheen on your backdrop. With fleece in particular, you won't get that. So, special for our creator series, if you're watching during the first week of the broadcast only, 70% off site-wide any backdrop you choose to go with. That's a deal you cannot beat. If you're watching at a later time after that first week, click the link below to get the discount code and see what the current specials are. You gotta add these to your studio. All right, next victim. What lens do you want?
I think I'm gonna do 85.
85, okay.
I think the way I'm gonna go with it is I'm gonna go ahead and have the rectangle on 45 degree on the left side softbox.
So 3x4. Okay, so we'll have this set up, camera left.
I am gonna go ahead and bring our straight edge over here, and I do want a hair light.
Okay, so we can use that Octa. So the next thing I need you to do is pick your backdrop.
I did not think that I would use that one, but I just might do it. If I want to do a second one, how long do you think it takes? Like three minutes?
You'll probably lose 3 minutes, two minutes to switching. But you're already taking way too much time to pick one, so let's go.
Just do it. Oh God, did I break something? Perfect, look at that. It's like you know what you're doing.
Yeah, I watched a few YouTube videos. Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
This guy, can we bring my side light a little bit more to her side, please?
So you're going with two lights from the side, not from behind her?
Gotcha.
Sorry.
That's all good. Tell me what to do, it's what I'm here for.
Sorry, I'm not used to that. No, it's dark, I just felt like I was losing time on
you are?
Because I'm so dramatic. This is an awful
lot. Time check for you, 7.5 minutes.
Good, we're good. All right, just very delicate fingers, kind of one up a little bit, and you're almost gonna like bring your fingers in just a smidge. There we go. Can I touch you? You okay with that? Okay. And bring these fingers in just a smidge. All right, give me a little bit more life in those eyes, so just take a minute. Even if it's this shot right here, we are good. You are beautiful and we are good. Yes, I love it. Those girls were happy. So on the count of three, just whatever comes natural. Yeah, and then just big smiles, okay? It's beauty, it's happy, and we're good. Yeah, there we go.
She started off very panicky, so I was starting to worry about her, but she has slowed down. Now she's getting into her own rhythm, and it looks like she's getting some good shots. I haven't seen the back of her camera. She's in her zone. I don't want to bother her, but she's finally calmed down.
I just want you to look up there, and on the count of three, you're just gonna go like a ha! Like, you know, like very old school, like ha ha! You know, and you're just gonna kind of do it towards there. All right, one, two, three. Ah! There we go.
You good?
Yeah.
All right,
time. Good job.
My plan going into it is really just the lighting. I didn't really know about the jewelry. I hadn't got to look at her up close or spend time with her, so I didn't really know what pose I was gonna do yet. I really just wanted to make sure I had the lighting correct first. And then when I got in there and I got to see her, it's kind of this vintage feel, picking a background that kind of has that vintage feel. So very like pinup style is kind of in my head. And she has a beautiful smile, and I feel like a lot of people don't do the smiles. I wanted to bring out that smile, so I'm hoping that one of those works out. I'm hoping what I brought to the table was just a little bit more expression. I'm hoping that that will help it stand out a lot more, as if I get more expression in her eyes, that the judges will be able to see that and recognize that and know that I had to do something extra to bring that out in her.
Here we go. Number five. Who's number five?
Hello.
Let's go, Laura.
You got this.
Oh, yeah.
What lens are we choosing today?
I think I'm going to stick with the 85.
85 millimeter, okay. F1.2 with the R5. We're going to use the Westcott trigger. Have you ever used Westcott before?
I have not.
Okay, so I'm your tech. I'm not going to tell you what to do,
right,
but I will do it for you, okay? So this is yours. So let's go pick a light. Okay. Tell me what we're doing.
You're doing butterfly lighting.
Okay.
So I want this to be diffused and shoot into it.
Okay, so we're gonna fire the strobe into this and then through the diffusion,
yeah,
soften it even more.
Yeah.
Okay, I got you. Camera right or camera left?
Right in front.
You want it over you. You're shooting this way.
Yeah, I'm gonna be here and she's gonna be there, and I want it right down on her.
My Green Renaissance 2. Okay, perfect. Girls, let's get this one set up.
I think I'm gonna do some butterfly lighting. So I want a nice big soft light above, and then a reflector underneath to soften all those shadows up. I want it to be as soft as possible, and I think that's the way I'm gonna achieve that light. So I'm really excited to see what we're gonna get out of it.
Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
Bring both hands up nice and soft right at your collarbones and look down towards the light for me. Perfect.
So we got some floral colors here. You can hold out in front of the lens. Thinking for her to wear or thinking to shoot through?
Well, I was thinking for her to wear, but I kind of like the idea of shooting through.
Three minutes.
Yep, right there, perfect.
All right, time. We had the whole crew working on that one, helping out, so good, all right.
We didn't have a shoot through umbrella, and we didn't have a really big modifier that I wanted, so we kind of made one up. So we did a white umbrella, and then we did a diffuser in front to really, really soften that light up. And that's pretty much what I use at home, but it's all one piece. I think the most stressful part of the time wasn't that I had too little time. I just felt like I had too much time and I didn't know what to do with it. I kind of knew what I was doing a little bit going into this challenge because it's something that I do a lot. And then I was just making up poses as I went because I didn't know what else for her to do. I think I accomplished what I wanted. I have a couple good, really good shots in there that I'm excited to look at.
All right, here we go. Next up, number six. Here we go. All right. Keely, what lens are we choosing?
I think we're gonna go with 85 for now.
85, okay. And we're gonna use the Westcott system. What light you wanna go with? What setup?
I think we're gonna do this bad boy right here.
Okay, so we're gonna use the Octa Amp. This is a beauty dish.
Oh.
And then we've got an umbrella. I mean, cool.
We're gonna use these two.
These two.
Yeah. Main fill.
Okay.
I'm gonna show, it's gonna be quirky.
Okay, we'll do your thing.
I want a light above reflecting kind of like top of the head and shoulders, and then reflector down here.
Okay.
And then this one's gonna like key in a kind of like key, but also fill. I think I wanna stick with a nice solid white backdrop. This cream is really nice. It'll just give me a good base. Haven't really worked with backdrops like this before. I'm usually just working on like a seamless. So this will be interesting. And then for lighting, I think we're gonna go, I'm gonna try and do a lot of stuff,
but I think I want to start off with this backlit kind of edge frame light, and that's going to be like the key, and then reflector from below to kind of bounce that light right into the face. If that's not giving me what I want it to give, then I'm going to come from the side with an umbrella, use that as a key, and then we'll move from there. We'll try a bunch of stuff.
Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
I want hands involved, but not too much. So maybe something like this in front of your face. Yeah, that's beautiful.
Get right in here. That's good.
3 minutes.
Cool.
One minute.
Wow, you're just doing so good. Just be here in your presence.
Yeah, I'm not doing anything. Yeah, put me to work, Keely. Time.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Good job.
Woo! I feel like I did a lot in a very little amount of time, which is what I wanted to do today. I really hope I got that beginning shot down. That first lighting setup is exactly what I wanted to do. I'm not quite sure if I got there. Really fun experimenting with like different things. I didn't realize how much I was gonna throw in there in terms of variation, but I feel good about it. Very nervous, and it'll all come down to editing at this point, so we'll see if I can do it.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the lights the contestants are using today on the show. They are using the FJ400, and this is a powerhouse light, right? So it's coming in at about $599. You can check it out on the Westcott site. We'll have the link below in the description. About 480 full power flashes that you'll get out of this. We use these in our studio. It's the perfect in-studio and on-location light. So if you're looking for that light where you can go, okay, I'm shooting outdoor portraits, we're shooting in-studio as well, and I want that one light that will be able to move across and put out enough power, this is the one you want in your bag. And again, at $599, not very expensive for a strobe that's putting out 400 watts per second. And of course, all the quality adapters and light modifiers that come with Westcott, this is definitely something to consider. So check out the link below. All right, here we go. Next up. Good. Who's number seven?
All right. Yeah.
You coming for the title?
All right, let's do it. All right.
Get it, girl.
Margo, what lens are we going with today? Too many choices?
Yes. 70 to 200.
Okay. You're. Are you asking me or telling me?
I'm asking.
No, you can't ask me.
Oh,
this is your choice.
Oh, shoot. Okay. Let's do the 7200.
Final decision
yes.
has been made. Okay.
I'm gonna keep it simple.
Okay. So we'll go with an Octa M. Okay, so this will be your main light. You want one light, multiple lights.
Can I add a light later?
We can build on it.
I think I may go with that strip a little bit later.
Later. Mm-hmm. So we're just gonna start with one light setup. All right, let's pick your backdrop.
I am going to take a chance and I'm going to go with this one.
Beige cement.
Uh-huh. My plan for the shoot is I'm gonna keep it simple, just keep it with one light. I'm gonna try to focus on like more old Hollywood vintage. I love her hair, I love the colors and her beautiful eyes. So I wanna kind of capitalize on that. So wish me luck. I wanna do kind of like a clamshell.
Okay, so you want it closer to you?
Mm-hmm.
And then what, like a reflector underneath?
And a reflector underneath.
Perfect. Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
We're gonna start with, we're gonna do like a vintage type look. Hands, beautiful. Turn your head towards the light. Perfect, gorgeous.
One thing I'm noticing is that every photographer so far has struggled with hands with Brooklyn. And I think that's a combination of two things. One, they're missing that detail. And two, Brooklyn, as a model, is not very good with her hands. And that's okay, because clients aren't always gonna be good with their hands. And as a photographer, you gotta figure out how to get them to have soft hands. And I'm seeing a lot of pictures where we're seeing the back of her hand, that camera, and it's just gonna make it look huge in the frame. So we'll see what happens, but I'm noticing a trend here. Talk to me, what are you thinking?
So I was thinking about adding some elements to it.
For holding them or shooting through it?
What are
you
doing?
Okay, so I'll hold it for you. Two and a half minutes. One minute. Five, Four, three, two, one. Time.
Got it.
Good job. Hey, no chimping. That's for later. All right. High five. Hey, where are you going? She's gone. She doesn't even want to.
I did my best.
I think that I didn't do as well as I wanted to. I think I was more so in my head versus calming down, taking my time to breathe, and then shooting, dialing in. But at the end of the day, I think there's maybe like two or three in there that I think I can work with. I wanted to add in a strip light, but I let my nerves kick in, but I did switch into a larger modifier. So let's see what happens.
All right, all right. All right, who's number eight?
Maybe me.
Let's go, baby.
Let's go. All right, guys.
Josh, what lens are you choosing today?
I'm going to use the 70-200.
70-200, yeah. Perfect.
I want to be able to compress just a little bit.
All right, I like it. And the camera's in manual mode. We're using the Canon R5. Okay. Assuming you're familiar with both of them.
I've had about a week to learn the Canon system.
Well, it's the best camera.
Yeah.
Shameless plug. Yeah. Let's go pick some lights.
Okay. Ideally, I would use like a 7-foot big one. So I want
we got 3x4.
I think I'm going to go with that one.
Okay.
Would love an highlighter.
We don't have one. We'll have a reflector.
We'll go with a reflector and kind of just make do with what we can and make it happen.
Okay.
So I really want to go with something simple, but not plain, if that makes sense. I want to really compliment the dress and the hair.
Canyon. Yeah. All right, let's set up
let's
Canyon.
Do it. Okay, so I'm just about ready to shoot, and my plan is to create something so I shoot really moody stuff. I also don't really work in a backdrop setting very much, so I want to try to go with how to mix my backdrop or the backdrop with my moody style shooting. So I want to keep it dark, that way I can pull out Brooklyn's red hair, because I love the red hair and the green dress. It just makeup, hair, that team is on point. It looks amazing. So I'm excited to shoot it. And I want to have a dark background and then bring out the color of her hair, her beautiful eyes, and just see what I can do and mix my style with honestly something that I don't know much.
Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes.
We gotta have fun with it. You're the most beautiful assistant I've ever had, so.
2 minutes, thank you. I take that to heart.
That's what I'm looking for.
Time.
Thank you so much. You're so awesome. Wow. So first of all, 10 minutes goes really fast. I feel like that I got the shot. I either got the shot right away or at the end. I won't know until I can actually see him. I feel like the next half hour or so before we get to edit, I'm just gonna be a nervous wreck. Probably more nervous than I was. I had an idea coming in here, and as soon as I got the camera in my hand and Sal said it was time to go, like all of that disappeared. I still feel like that I created what I was wanting to do. With this challenge and with the Creator Series, I want to step out of my element a lot and show that I'm not just a one lens, one man band with one light and stuff. So if I continue, I'm gonna really push myself to create something more. I mean, that's top creator needs to be able to do a lot of stuff, right? So let's see what happens.
Two more left. Who's number nine? Let's go, Anthony. All right, Anthony, what lens are we going with today?
I'm gonna go with the 85.
85, 1-2, okay. So let's pick some lights. What do you want to start with? Big octa?
Yeah.
So, right, we got a medium, large, you want
that's
the large?
Large.
Okay, you going with one light?
I'm gonna go with two,
okay.
And I'll use that smaller octa as well.
Now you will have the time until the backdrop goes up to get your lights dialed in.
Okay.
And then the clock starts going.
Okay.
All right.
I'm gonna go with the beige cement.
Okay.
A little bit safe, a little bit not so safe. Model, hair, makeup, all look fantastic. I myself am gonna work towards being fantastic during this challenge. With soft beauty, I do a lot of beauty work. I love hard light, so this is a little bit of a challenge for me. So I think I'm gonna kind of keep things close, keep things intimate, keep things bright, keep things soft, and just kind of crush this challenge best I can.
Much better, nice light. Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes. We got a third light, Anthony.
Yeah, yeah.
You wanna throw a light on it?
Yeah, okay. Cute. Cute, you're doing all the great things.
Hey. 2 minutes.
Okay, let's change nothing right this second. You look great.
I'm kind of fake laughing. Oh, I'm so happy to be here. Today's almost over. What do we got,
20 seconds?
10 seconds. Let's just high-five it out.
All right. Time.
I did absolutely nothing that I had intended. I totally froze, just being honest, and just trying to figure out what I wanted and how to articulate that in a short amount of time was different. I'm not used to working with an assistant, so having Sal was great, but I'm used to just grabbing things on my own. And for some reason, I just kind of got a little shook up and tried a couple things. So I think there's a couple things in there that I feel really good about, and Brooklyn was great. So we're gonna see what we get at the end.
All right, all right. And then there was one.
All right.
All right, Andre, what lens we going with?
Start off with the 28-70.
Okay, so we'll switch to the 28-70 f2, a personal favorite of mine. Getting a lot of range on that. Okay, and let's go pick some lighting.
Cool. I'm gonna start off with the Octa L.
Okay, so we'll use the Octa L here. Are you gonna do one light?
I'm gonna start off with one light. Hopefully I got enough time to switch to something.
Okay, Fresco cream, let's get it going.
I have absolutely no idea what I'm gonna do yet. One light portraits seem simple enough, but you know, the simplest thing can turn into the biggest nightmare. So we'll just see what we're gonna get. First, I know I'm gonna start off with the Rabbit Box Octa L. That's probably where I'm gonna go. Gonna try to utilize as much of the 10 minutes as possible, maybe change backgrounds. We'll see what we get.
Hey Siri, set timer, 10 minutes. All yours, Andre. Five minutes.
Chin down and care.
4 minutes, Andre. Thirty seconds, Andre.
Right here.
Five, four, three, two, one, time. Good job, man.
I definitely thought I would move a little bit quicker, change out the background if I got to that point, but that 10 minutes is a monster. 10 minutes is not enough time to do anything at all. But hopefully we got some good stuff to keep me here in the competition for another day. We'll see how it goes.
All right, there it is. I do have a question. How'd that feel?
Horrible.
Horrible?
Not horrible, it was just tough.
Just tough? Was it what you thought it was gonna be?
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely not.
Some said yes, some said absolutely not.
Yes. The hardest part is waiting after we shoot.
You've been waiting all day.
Yeah. All right guys, so this is it. 30 minutes to pick and edit your pictures. Look, I'm gonna tell you, don't get lost in Photoshop. Pick smartly, okay? And understand what the challenge was. So focus on the challenge, because that would be an immediate way for you to start losing some points as the judges start critiquing this, all right? So here we go, the countdown begins, 30 minutes.
Yes! Okay.
Hey Siri, set timer, 30 minutes. All right, here we go, shit's getting real. 20 seconds left. Start saving it out. I need a JPEG file. Time. Today's challenge was soft light beauty portraits, so that was the task for them. They had their choice of backdrops, lighting, and I was teching for them, so they were driving and making decisions. You know, one of the things jumping out at me just as we're going through this is just their struggle with hands, on a lot of them.
I'm noticing also a lot of these just are not soft light.
Yeah.
Well, that one has pretty, pretty hard
light. It's a
heavy
Rembrandt on that one.
Soft, I don't think we can get hung up on the soft light because most of them are not.
Yeah, so everybody's going home. Right? Challenge number one.
See you later.
Yeah. So no, I think to that point, that's going to have to be something we're giving them constructive feedback on for their lack of that. This is softish. I like the toning. I like the edit of it.
Here's my stickler. They're gorgeous portraits, but they're not beauty. Beauty commercial. Isn't just a pretty photo. A beauty is a cropped portrait from the chest up. That's what it's supposed to be. That's a stunning photo, but it's just not the goal.
This is creative, but there's so many not soft light pieces to this. The edge light is actually way too harsh for me. I almost feel like there's color banding going on over there.
At least she went for it with a crazy background and crazy foreground framing her. So if she would have been a clean background with that thing in the foreground, it would have been like, okay, that doesn't quite fit, but it all comes together pretty well. She has like a 1950s flight attendant look thing.
It's kind of funny, like, because this particular pose and expression, I'm not overly a fan of.
Yeah.
But if you think back to that period of time, it does look like it.
The texture in the skin is really, really nice, though.
It will be amazing to have soft light with some contouring going on. This is just soft light. There's no contouring. This one has some contouring going on. And that's still relatively soft light. I mean, that's a hell of a picture right there.
Yeah. That is good, but right, you start running into other elements that are problematic. Well, the hand. The hand's not in motion, and I think this is where you start getting even more critical.
The shoulder here competes with the face, right? Yeah. So if she would have, or if the photographer would have gone like this, just brought the shoulder back, you would have been right on the face. And then the palm of the hand at eye level.
Yeah, the palm is brutal.
Such a crazy thing how you can have the same model, same light, same setup, and every photo looks so darn different.
This image I'm struggling with big time here because it is way too cluttered in the frame.
Oh, that's it? There's no zoom out?
No.
No,
that's the photo.
Yeah, that's okay.
I thought you were zooming in and out.
I don't mind a close crop, especially for beauty. I actually generally love a macro, but this is so heavy. There's nowhere for the eye to rest.
Yeah, beautiful expression, good hair light. And then you crop the hair light.
Here's another one where I struggle with the hands.
You need to break up the hands. I always say, think about a dancer and just kind of break up the hand a little bit so it's not so hard.
I like how they tried to include some foreground elements here, but it's also off balance because there's nothing up top.
Yeah.
Yeah, no shadowing.
Very bright highlights.
Ooh, that's just
it looks
hard.
Almost overexposed.
They had the ability to adjust this. They're all shooting raw. So that's all the images. What I want to see us do is pick our winner first. We'll see if we can do this on our own.
I can definitely tell you right now, I feel very strong about the winner.
Okay. So, do we feel like we have a winner?
We
agree on the winner?
Yes.
Okay, they did a great job. Do we feel like we have three people that unfortunately didn't make the cut?
Yeah.
Sad.
All great photographers, but it's a competition.
Good
photo. Personal. Let's send the winner to print. Okay, so how was the day? Tough?
Yeah.
All right, well, we saw a lot of images come from you guys, and I do want to talk about beauty portraits in general, but first I want to introduce the people that are to my left and right. To my right is Roberto Valenzuela. He is a Canon Explorer of Light, best-selling author, and a fashion and commercial photographer. He'll be joining us for judging during the entire series. To my left is Taylor Brumfield. She is a Westcott Top Pro, Tamron Ambassador, and a commercial product and beauty photographer. And so you've got a great crew in front of you that are going to give you some feedback, some good, some bad. First, I do want Taylor to take the lead here because as we were judging the images, one thing that really did jump out at us is there seemed to be confusion in what a beauty portrait was. And I know that was something we had to bend the rules a little bit to get through this, or maybe everybody was going home tonight.
A beauty portrait is not simply a beautiful photo. A beauty portrait is specifically a photo from the chest, the mid-chest, up to the top of the head. However, you can also have macro portraits, which are going to be cropped in, but that needs to be zoned in on the face. Beauty specifically, especially in the portraiture world, needs to be at least from the chest up.
We wanted to be fair to everybody who submitted, and so we kind of put that rule to the side. Won't say it didn't weigh in on some of our decisions, but we did put that to the side, and we'll make sure that we are being a little bit more specific and clear as the challenges move on. Before we get started, for those of you watching from home, we know that last year everybody had an opinion on who should have won, who got robbed, and so if you go down into the description and you click the link, you can actually enter your vote, and we have a way for you to win a prize when you register and submit your vote. We're giving away a ticket to Shutterfest 24 and Shutterfest Plus, as well as you can win a free FJ80, FJ200, and a trigger from Westcott, and so it's worthwhile. Submit your vote so we can see what you guys think and have to say. All right, so without further ado, I'm sure you're all dying to know who is the winner of the Soft Light Beauty Portrait Challenge. So let's show that image. Andre, step up. Congratulations. Just gonna start off real quick. Did a lot of things right here. Beautiful lighting. I feel where you missed on this was expression and face angle. She just, to me, looked like a thumb was the analogy I gave, where her chest, face, everything's facing that same angle.
This is an example of simplicity done really well. When you look at this photo, she pops out, and that's your expertise in lighting and how well you executed that lighting. Even her arm is contoured with lighting. You can see the shadowing going on. And the editing was beautiful. The background was simple, and it had to be because it's a beauty portrait. So you nailed it, in my opinion. The hair light and the composition of your photo, fire. I mean, everything was fire, you know? A couple of little things like what Sal said, but other than that, dude, that's perfect.
So, Andre, congratulations. Your journey continues. And also, Andre, you are the winner of the H&H 30 by 40 fine art product. And so you can have your choice of metal, canvas, or fine art paper. So congratulations, $350 value. Thank you, H&H. All right, next image. Step on up, Chris.
So a couple of things that struck me when I looked at this image. First of all, the center of the face is very hot. I would have brought that exposure down a good half stop, three quarters of stop, something like that, just so that the center wasn't so hot. I actually liked the warmth of the grade. I would have put just a little bit of coolness to balance out maybe in the shadows, just a little bit. I really like the specular light in the eyes. The model has gorgeous irises, and I really like how you were able to bring all of those tiny little differences in color out. Just a couple of things, you know, with the exposure.
Chris, congratulations, your journey continues.
This is fun.
So the lighting in the background is very similar to the lighting on her face. And in a beauty portrait, they're both now competing. There's a bit of an issue there. The hair light is really nice, but the fact that the luminosity levels are pretty even throughout the photo, it makes me wonder what the subject really is, you know? I mean, obviously it's her, but it's fighting itself, right? Nice job on the turn of the head. Whenever you have a beauty shot and the shoulders are competing with it, trouble. Nicely done though.
Congratulations, Anthony, your journey continues. Come on forward. You were a hot mess. I mean, that's just it. Bottom line, you were a hot mess the entire shoot. And if I can encourage you to do anything, it's to get out of your own way. I know you were not in your element, and that's a testament to what you're capable of as a photographer and as an artist if you can get out of this headspace, right? So great job on the image. Overall, the judges really did enjoy the image. Good choice of backdrop. It allowed some separation and differentiation from her to the background. It's not so sharp or so in focus that it's distracting, so I felt like it was good balance. But I think what really made the, you can't cry, that's no good. You're gonna get me choked up. All right, I think what really did a good job on this were the hands. It was a classic kind of pose for the hands. It was different than what anyone else had done, and so great job. All right, congratulations. Your journey continues. Next image, come on up. I'm not gonna lie, Laura, I'm gonna let the other judges weigh in on this. You were on my chopping block to go home with this image, and I'll share with you why. Hands. So this was a really big problem for me, being able to see the difference between her chest to the left hand to the right hand, right? It's just one giant blob of skin, and I found that to be incredibly distracting. And because of the tight crop, her hands, to me, were competing with her face, and it's a beauty portrait. You did not vote for this, too.
I didn't vote for it. What I like about this is, first of all, it is a true beauty portrait, and I can appreciate that for this challenge. I like the eye contact here as well. I'm very big on eye contact in beauty portraits. If you're going to have the eye contact, make it mean something. The hands, for me, were not a strong point. I call it claw hand. I can't stand claw hand. There needs to be some sort of breakup in that line, so have them raise a finger, or think of what a dancer would do to kind of break up that line so it's not so aggressive. But I like the light on top of the hair. I think that it gives some gorgeous definition to her curls. And then again, I really like the expression.
Laura, congratulations. Your journey continues. Next image, come on up.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Margo, I don't know if you know this, we're having a challenge here. It's called Creator Series. You're on it.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
This is a constant situation that happened with a lot of the contestants. The shoulder is fighting the face. Here's my face, here's my shoulder. If you bring the shoulder back, the face pops up forward. When you use a lens that compresses that, it makes the face look very prominent. If you forget that, the shoulders are naturally wider than the person's head. And then it makes the shoulders the most important part of the photo. The hands, I think, are pretty good. There's contouring on the arm. The lighting on the face is good, and your composition is perfect. A tiny bit of the forearm from the shoulder to the elbow would have been beneficial.
If you look at these two images, yours and Andre's side by side, they're very similar poses, right? And one of the things that put him over the top was controlling that one arm. It was still in the portrait, but it was slimmed because it was pulled back, right? You don't want it forward and prominent. And one other thing, right? This is a beautiful portrait. You should be very proud. But one other thing in this is not soft light beauty portrait. The shadows are very hard. There's a very distinctive line going from light to shadow, right? That contrast. Great job, Margo. Your journey continues. All right, only one of you is moving forward in the challenge. So this was a very difficult decision for us. All right, next image. Step forward, Deshaun. Congratulations. So Deshaun, I will tell you, there were a lot of problems with this image, but you won a lot of bonus points on creativity.
You just took some risks, man. You believed in yourself, you took risks. And there's two approaches. There's his approach, which was simplicity at its best and perfection, really. And then there's crazy amounts of awesome risk-taking. And in a competition, we have to reward both, right? And you're a risk-taker here. You had a great background that kind of goes crazy, and then you have the crazy foreground that frames her, and then you have that crazy hard light that did not do you any favors, but at least you're trying to contour the face. And that effort, I thought, was enough for you to be saved.
So Deshaun, congratulations. Your journey continues. Team, step forward. It's a tough day today. I know many of you on a personal level, you guys did awesome. You came here, you brought the heat. It was not easy, the deliberation. We went back and forth on a lot of things for your images. So let's give you some critique on each one of these images. Keely, I believe this was your image. This was very difficult. It was also difficult for me while I was watching you shoot. I just wanted to grab you and pull you back to give you some breathing room in this, and I just couldn't interject myself. The expression, Roberto was your biggest fan on this. The expression, Taylor loved it as well. You actually captured an expression from Brooklyn that felt quite natural, that quite honestly no one else did capture. What ultimately killed you here was the crop. It's just too tight.
It actually wasn't. It was pulled back, and I made that decision.
You brought it in.
Watched it.
You stand by it, that's fine. It is a beautiful image. Those are the types of things that killed it. We lost the top of her head in not a good way on the crop, and then her neck, it's just a floating head at that point. And so that was a really difficult decision for us to make, all right? So, hey, your journey as an artist is just getting started. You got a bunch of great stuff ahead of you. Keep up the good work. Keep moving forward, all right? Next image.
You did a pretty darn good job on this. The problem here, mainly, the expression is dead. And there is just zero for us to grab onto. It is the opposite of what she did. Like, she had like an amazing expression. And in this one, it almost looks scared. And I gotta say, from my perspective, this happens when you're not interacting with the model in a very positive, dynamic, energetic, and fun way. It seems like you were probably talking to her behind the camera. Maybe you were feeling nervous. I don't know what's going on, but that energy transcribed to this. It was too much for us to get through.
Josh, same thing, right? You're an incredible photographer. You're an incredible educator. You take that feedback, you take it to heart, you get better the next time you go at it, right? This is not the end of your journey at all. Next image.
I actually don't dislike this image. There are just a couple key points that I feel like maybe sink it below some of the others. You know, the competition is tight, you know, so every single aspect has to hit. Some of the things that did stick out to me, I feel like the crop, I would have dropped it just a little bit so that maybe there was a gap between her body and her arm. Otherwise, it's just a lot of green.
If you could see that whole image, I just cropped for the beauty.
But sometimes you have to take that slight risk in order to balance the photo. That's something I find that I have to do as a beauty photographer as well, is just maybe drop it a little bit so that it's visually balanced, because that's what, you know, ultimately matters. And then her arm, it seems accidental. I think there just needs to be a little bit more purpose in the arm, as well as, you know, what I was calling claw hand. But the eye contact here, I think, is really, really strong.
Carolina, I think the hand is what pushed it down below, is that just looking at the palm of that hand looks like a huge hand. Each of you did something that if we took all three of your images and put them into one, it probably would have been the winning image, right? This is not the end at all. We wish you well, but your journey will not continue on the Creator Series. Good luck, guys. And for those of you at home, if you want a chance to vote on who you think the winner should have been, go down into the description, go to our Creator Series webpage and cast your vote. We'll see you in episode 2.
I'm over the moon. I can't even front. I honestly didn't expect that my image was gonna win. I knew that it was really solid in terms of like the basics, right? Which is kind of what I was going for. But I saw some of the other images from the other contestants. I thought that they were fantastic. So, you know, I didn't know which way it was gonna go, but I'm glad it went in my favor.
Like I said in the beginning, backgrounds are not my element. Overall, I was going for a more surprised look, and it didn't come out. So that's on me. It's not on the model. The model is amazing. I love working with her. That's okay. I'm not upset. Super honored, humbled to be here, and just keep going, making bangers.
I knew going into it, I was really proud of my technical capabilities. My biggest regret as I sat back there for hours waiting was I knew all the images had a hand. I knew it. And I thought, okay, well, it's a beauty image. I need to remove the hand or I need to figure something else out. And so I thought, well, it's a beauty image, I have to crop. So it is very frustrating to see the results and see full bodies making it. I am proud of myself as a creator. I picked up my camera almost 3 years ago, and to see where I am beyond proud of myself. I've made such growth, but it sucks that I can't show you the most that I can do because I was ready to kick this competition's butt.
I'm feeling good. I'm super grateful that I was able to be here. Phenomenal competitors, beautiful people. There wasn't an ounce of jealousy, envy. We're all super creative. We're all super supportive. Not a single bad photographer on this roster. So super, super grateful to be here. I think I did a great job. I think I nailed it. I think that, you know, my portrait was a beauty portrait. I think that the model was super happy with how she looked. I loved her expression. I loved the photo that I chose. Cropped in maybe a little bit too tight, but honestly, that's what I wanted. So I'm not mad. Good luck to everyone else.